December 13th, 2014, Saint-Denis, France. I'm not showing my whole screen because I, oh no, this is not working. Because I do not want problems about copyright or anything from YouTube. Okay. Oh, I can't find the story now. This is my second attempt at this. Oh, trying to get this article up. Sorry. I don't edit. I don't provide links. So this is just raw. Okay. He sold his illness. It's on LeParisien.fr on my yahoo.fr page. The man, a man who got a residency card, they're called titre de séjour, to be cared for AIDS in France, used his illness to obtain papers for others. His modus operandi, which had never been seen before, has given something to think about, I suppose, that means, to Parisian police officers, and they're investigating this. He's from the Côte d'Ivoire, the Ivory Coast. He's in his 50s, and they think that he got several hundred titre de séjour, residency papers, entry papers, for foreigners without papers. And he was put in jail several weeks ago. He's been sick with AIDS for years and had a carte de séjour, a temporary residency card, in the name of his health condition to permit him to be cared for. And then he used this thing to get other people in, and it permitted him, because of his health status, to get papers for illegal aliens so that they could stay on French soil. He got many of these cards, which are good for 1 year, but they were automatically renewed, given the fact that these people were so sick. You know, they supposedly have AIDS, and this hadn't really come to police attention because they have the medical secret laws in France. You know, your doctor cannot fill out insurance forms for you. Your doctor cannot talk to another doctor with regard to your health. Your health is your own issue here in France. If you're sick, your spouse and your family does not have to know unless you want them to know. Your doctor can only write a general letter of referral for other doctors, and then you get there and you give the permission, and the doctor can release some basic information. Now, a doctor has been involved in this. He was charging between 2,000 and 3,000 euros, according to a judiciary source. He billed the renewal at around 500 euros. It seems that this has been going on since 2008. And there were several hundred foreigners who arrived in France without their legal permit. And this is the first time that this has come up as far as the police and immigration are concerned. Let's see, according to our information, let's see the rest of the article. The Parisian police put in charge of this delicate inquiry came on Thursday to identify one of the principal accomplices of all of this, a doctor more than 60 years old in Paris. Okay, he's on garde à vue, which I think means he's arrested in a way. I mean, it could be locked up. I think it means that he's formally charged and he can't go anywhere and stuff. He's suspected to have given a lot of prescriptions and for HIV tests under different names. The tests were done in a hospital place or in private laboratories. The man at the origin of this fraud went to the laboratories or to the hospital with a prescription in the name of the people who had come to him to do this, and once the diagnosis of AIDS had been established, the clients of the fraud guy had to go to the prefecture with these tests to get their resident card, temporary resident card, but as I've said, they would get automatically renewed because the people were supposedly so sick. Okay, a fault in the surveillance system. Yeah, I'll say. Boy, I had to go through heck to get to France. I had to get a blood test. I had to pay for it. I think they were doing psychiatric testing on me. I mean, it was just interviews. I had to go alone and do them in French and stuff, but it was a lot. I had to be there. I had to pay things. It took a long time. Okay. At the moment when he showed up in the labs or at the hospital, nobody asked for his identity, even though the hospitals here are supposed to do that for basic security reasons. When we asked the hospitals why they didn't identify all of their patients, they said that we're not here to do the work of the police. And as far as the labs were concerned, they basically just answered, well, we're in this to make money. Okay, the fraud guy who lives in a big, comfortable apartment in Bobigny, which is the prefecture and the département I'm in, that's where I had to go for my immigration, may have sent a lot of the money he got from doing this back to the Ivory Coast. Many tens of, twelves of thousands of euros have been probably sent back to the Ivory Coast. The man also hired a woman who does have AIDS to help illegal aliens to get false papers in this way. His system was perfectly planned, I think it says, and he was getting a lot of requests. All right. Okay. See you later. Bye.